And to the second part, as I have already explained, we can also calculate the displacement from velocity time graph. Now let us see how. Right, now we know that displacement is equal to average velocity into time. Now average velocity is v1 plus v2 divided by 2, and time taken is naturally, that is t2 minus t1. Now putting v1, what is v1 here? V1, if you come to the, this is a1, v2 is bb1, this is bb1 divided by 2, and t2 minus t1 is, this is a1 b1. So if you observe carefully, what is this? This is half sum of the sides into the perpendicular distance between them, which is the area of this trapezium. This is the trapezium, the area of this trapezium. So you can write that is equal to area of trapezium, or we can say area under the graph. Area under the graph for which we have taken the time measurements graph. Because we are measuring for t2 minus t1. If we are measuring from 0 to t2, then this whole area will be considered as the displacement. So from this graph, velocity time graph, what we have concluded? We have concluded that number one, acceleration is given by slope of the graph, and this is really very important. Second, displacement is given by area under the graph. ठीक है. Moreover, one more thing that we can get from this velocity time graph is the velocity at any instant of time, at particular instant of time. So third importance is we can get velocity of object at any instant of time from the graph.